Let's give a listen. First poem is about a young kid who comes to New York with a dream. Just like all of us, so we can relate to this. It's called Journey to New York. Standing in front of the club, he felt a faint breeze skimming the First Avenue, swirling dust, ankle high, reaching up, stinging his face, reminding him he was no longer in a dead-end town. Tired of that place, he packed up, one day, headed out, straight down the highway, took the high-span view over the George Washington Bridge, feeling the misty outline of Manhattan, gray turrets, piercing the clouds, brightly colored banners, soldiers in armor, beckoning him to come with his dreams. Stepping back now, he looked up and down the avenue. Nothing moving, nothing to see. The dream within still burned white. Self-taught on the guitar, he spent long nights searching for the right words. And solitary days practicing, practicing until his fingers cramped and bled. At the clubs, he met some ladies, had some fans, but when the agent stopped calling, he stayed, while the others he knew slipped away, leaving behind broken dreams, empty backpacks, and borrowed shoes. Now the club begins to fill up. Not an empty table, lights dim, a stray cough punctuates the silence. Alone on stage, he eases into the mic. His voice carries the song. The audience leans to hear words meant for them. He connects and they with him. The devil is in the room, the club is transformed, and after all those years, his chance is now. Thank you. Another poem from this area, 14th Street, The Lady Waits Alone. And when you think about it, what lady in the village sleeps alone? I can't figure this one out. The lady waits alone. She knew everyone, writers, artists, street performers, and everyone who knew everyone. Attractive with a warm smile, she could be bewitching and charming at the same time. With an understanding of the art world and a sharp eye for detail, she introduced guests who had ideas to guests who had money. Drinks in hand, the hostess and host spent much of the evening entertaining their company. There was a 20-year difference between them. Always near her side, he was quiet, a thinker, some said, who feared that at his age, there really was not much more he could accomplish. Standing on the balcony near 14th Street, the view of the city was breathtaking. Lights twinkled from the streets below, beckoning to him with the strangest of songs. Taking a deep breath, he hesitated for a moment, then left, intending to return. Party long ended. Propped up on a sofa, the hostess watched as a glimmer of light, bit by bit, inch by inch, turned from black to misty daybreak. Not moving, face up towards the ceiling, tears filled her eyes. Down below, a lone car speeds through the heart of the sleeping village, past the empty streets, the shuttered stores, past the ubiquitous bars, closed for the night. Scarcely 5:30 in the morning, the sun not fully up, the city, groggy from the night before, struggles to stir from an uneasy sleep. Thank you.